Good morning students, 7th standard, subject mathematics. So today we are going to start the new chapter, algebraic expressions. So what do you mean by algebraic expressions? These algebraic expressions, they are made up of variables and constant. These variables and constant, they combine to form a algebraic expression. See, for example, 4x plus 5, 10 by minus 20. See, these are the x is a variable and 5 is a constant. Similarly, this is a variable, this is a constant. And next, what do you mean by monomial, binomial and trinomial? See, if the expression consists of a one term, then it is called a monomial. If the expression it consists of two terms, then we call it as binomial. Similarly, if the expression is made up of three terms, then we call it as trinomial. And later, if the expression is more than three terms, then we call them polynomials. So next, exercise 12.1. In that first question, get the algebraic expression. See, they have given in a sentence, we have to write them in an algebraic expression. See, first one, subtraction of z from y. Z should be subtracted from y. Therefore, we should write the y first, next minus z. Therefore, the answer is y minus z. And the second one, numbers x and y both squared and added. So, these are the numbers x and y. First, we have to square them. Therefore, x square and y square. Then, we have to add them. And it is x square plus y square is the answer. And the second question is, identify terms and their factors and show them by tree diagram. We have to separate the terms and factors and we have to show them in a tree diagram. First question, x minus 3. See here, x is a term and 3 is a factor. How we should show them in a tree diagram? It should be like this. We have to write x here and minus 3 here. X is a term and minus 3 is a factor. And the second one, 1 plus x square. See, we have three terms in an expression. We have to write them as 1 here and x here, and this is x square. Again, we can separate the x square as x and x. So this is how we write them in tree diagram. So second one, identify terms and factors. Again, in this also we have to identify the terms and factors. So the first question is, minus 4x plus 5. See, in this expression, these two are all terms. Therefore, the terms are minus 4x and 5. This expression is made up of two terms. And what about the factors? So, this is a term, minus 4x and 5. In factors, we have to separate this numerator and numerical value and also the variable. That is constant and a variable. So, it is minus 4, x and 5. See, these three are the factors of this expression. And the third question is, identify the numerical coefficient of terms. So, the first question is 5 minus 3 t square. We have to identify the coefficients of a term. First, let us consider the term. See, the term must contain the variable. So, we have to take the minus 3 t square. 5, it is a constant. We can't consider it as a term. And the coefficient of minus 3 t square. Coefficient of this is minus 3. Similarly, the second question, 1.2a plus 0.8b. So, what are the terms of this expression? 1.2 is a one term and 0.8b is a another term. Then the coefficients. So, this contains 1.2a. The coefficient of a is 1.2. See, this is a variable. We can't consider it as a coefficient. Therefore, the coefficient of a is 1.2 and the coefficient of b is 0.8. And the fourth question is, identify the terms which contain x and also write the coefficient of x. See, first question, y square x plus y. In this expression, we have two terms, but only one term contains the x, that is y square x. Therefore, the terms with x is only one term. y square x, and the coefficient of x is, this is the coefficient of x, that is y square. And similarly, the second question, identify terms which contain y square and write the coefficient of y square. See, first question, 2x square y minus 15xy square plus 7y square. In this expression, we have three terms, but only two terms contains the y square. See, in this we have only one y. We can't consider this as a term which contains y square. Therefore, the terms with y square are minus 15xy square and 7y square. So, two terms. And the coefficient of y square. See, in this expression, the coefficient of y square is 15x, that is minus 15x. And in this, coefficient of y square is 7. Therefore, the coefficients of y square are minus 15x and 7. And the fifth one, classify the following. So, the first one is 4y minus 7z. See, we have to classify these three equations as monomial, binomial and trinomials. Already in introduction class, I have told you what you mean by monomial, binomial and a trinomial. See, first question, 4y minus 7z. See, this expression is made up of two terms. 4y is one term and minus 7z is another term. So, it is made up of two terms, hence it is a binomial. And the second one is y square. Here we have only one term, therefore we call it as monomial. And the third one is z square minus 3z plus 8. See, this expression is made up of three terms, so we call it as trinomial. And similarly, sixth one, state whether the following are like or unlike terms. See, what do you mean by like terms? So, the like terms, the algebraic factors should be same. See, the first question is 1 and 100. See, these two are the numerical numbers. So, we call them as like terms. And the second one is 12xz, 12x square, y square. See, to say the like terms, we have to consider the algebraic terms and their powers. See, here we have only xz. Here we have x square, z square. So, both are not same. We call them as unlike terms.